Health coverage in Thailand, and then talk about the benefit package for the HIV and AIDS patient in under universal coverage scheme in Thailand, and HIV prevention for key populations and challenges. For overview of the USC in Thailand, USA in Thailand is a long and complicated journey. The development pathway was not only on the health infrastructure, but also for the legislation to have a law about the USC in Thailand. Before 1945, in Thailand, most of the healthcare is the fee for service. Yes. The user must pay the fee to the hospital directly, not co-pay from the other from the government or from the employee. And in the 1920s, the exemption on health service for former worker and the poor was introduced. Prepayment was started to service later with health card project for near poor and the CSMBS scheme for government officer and dependents. And then the prepayment system were expanded in 1990s to other group in former worker or to the children and the elderly. And in the year 2000, we tried to implement the USC policy. The total health insurance coverage was estimated after we have the National Health Security Act in the year 2002. And now, after we achieved the universal health coverage in 2002, we have we have three schemes of healthcare service in Thailand. The universal coverage in Thailand now is nearly 100%. For the universal coverage in Thailand, that I tell you that we have three schemes of healthcare. The first is the civil servant medical benefit scheme for the civil servant and dependent is administered by the Ministry of Finance. And the second scheme is the social security scheme. It's for private employee in the formal sector. It's administered by Social Security Office, Ministry of Labor. And the last scheme is a universal coverage scheme, UCS. It's for the less of citizens that who's unemployed or in informal employment. Is administered by National Health Security Office. For about the Thai citizens that have three schemes of service. For CSMBS, for the government officer, is about 10% of Thai citizens. They have the benefit, they have the budget from the tax, for government tax only, to have the budget. And for the social security scheme, it's about 15% of the Thai citizens. We have tripartite contribution to be the budget. And the most is 75% of the Thai citizen UC a universal coverage. They have the tax to be the government budget totally. About NHSO, the National Health Security National Health Security Office, is an autonomous government organization. We are not the Ministry of Public Health. We are autonomous government organization established by the National Health Security Act in the year 2002 to manage the universal coverage scheme for the less of 48 million people, Thai people, about 35% of Thai citizens who do not cover by other government scheme. Now, for UC scheme or those universal coverage scheme, we go to the fourth strategic plan. Yes, the vision is everyone who lives in Thailand covered by USC and access to healthcare with confidence when needed. the goal, we have three goals. That's the first is the safe financing system. Second is the effective, equitable, and responsive coverage. And the third goal is the two good governance. For the budget, for government budget for UC in Thailand, in the years 2017 and this year, it's not the same. About 3,000 baht per capitation. Overall, UC budget is the government budget. Government fund is not funding to NSO for the UC. For the budget in UC, after we deduct the salary of the health staff under the government service unit, the net UC budget is classified to sub-fund for management. More than 90% of the net budget is managed as capitation for general health service or basic service. But the rest of the budget are managed as vertical program for system management and disease management. And for HIV and AIDS management, it's not per capitation budget. It's the extra budget from the basic budget. So we classify the benefit package that for basic health package for outpatient, inpatient, or prevention and promotion, we use the basic budget that per capitation, and we have the extra budget for ARV that for HIV, for renal replacement or for chronic care, secondary prevention for chronic care or mental health. About HIV and AIDS benefit package under the UC. Now we categorize the budget into three groups. Yes, for HIV budget, we categorize to first for HIV and AIDS treatment and care service. And the second group is to promoting system of HIV and AIDS service. And the third group is HIV prevention. For HIV care service, the first group is the most of the budget is for the ARV or ART, yes, and laboratory testing. And for the important thing that this budget is voluntary counseling and testing. And also for the follow-up and holistic care and for condom. For HIV patient, and now this year we have the hepatitis C screening and confirmed testing for HIV and AIDS population. The second group is the promoting system of HIV AIDS is for the quality of care. Yes, for quality improvement of lab or test or quality of drug. Yes, and the third group of the budget is for HIV prevention. That's we. Categorize to risk, recruit, test, treat, and retain. And result for the 1990 treatment target. Now, the first group for people living with HIV diagnosed, now we can get the 98%. But for the second group is the diagnosed people living with HIV are on treatment, we also have 87%. And for the third 90, that on the treatment have suppressed viral load, the outcome is 23%. The problem of this 1993 policy is the second group, because when the people were diagnosed to be HIV, they don't identify themselves in the government sector. So they go to have the treatment in the private sector that we have no data about them. So we cannot identify what the one from here go to the other side, so cannot calculate to be increase the outcome. And for the
the problem of the death group is the doctor decision. Some doctor in Thailand have a decision that if the patient have ARV early and well being, they don't send to test the well-known because it's their decision. We cannot negotiate them that all of the patient must.
And for the treatment, we are not divide or we are not access just for the key population. We access to the general population with HIV, but for prevention, the third group of budget, the prevention, we focus on the key population. This is the number of key population that have the prevention, which reach the first R in NSO. It's only from the UC scheme, not overall Thai people. In last year, for MSM and TG, nearly 80% of the population of the target have reached. For female sexual girls also 80%, and people with ID is 100%, and male sexual girls about 25%. The problem is our country have the cross social or have the problem about the culture, about the law. So key population don't want to identify themselves that I am a male sex worker or people with ID. Yes. So we have no exact number of the target of each group to deal with the prevention. So about the HIV in Thailand, we think that treatment is not a problem now, because even we have three scheme of service, but all three of scheme of service have a same treatment for the HIV patient. But the problem is to deal with the prevention program, because about prevention program for HIV now is only for the UC scheme. The CSMBS or SAS, no prevention program. And for UC now, NSO cannot deal with the working group, because we know that for prevention, the working group, not the hospital, should be the CSO or NGO. But now the problem is the Office of Auditor General of Thailand point that NSO cannot budgeting non-health service unit to the national due to the National Health Security Act. So we cannot funding to the NSO, we cannot funding to the NGO or to the CSO to work for the prevention program. So the challenge is how NSO direct budgeting to the working group. Yes, is maybe collect the law, collect the act, or have to talk together with multi partner. Yes, how to work together that to achieve the prevention goal. Yes. Thank you for my presentation.